Of all the counting techniques that we'll consider, none are more valuable than the two that are the topic of this video. They are the multiplication principle and tree diagrams. As an illustration, let's consider a fellow named Ed, who has three clean shirts, a white one, a blue one, and a yellow one. And he has two pairs of pants, a black pair and a gray pair. Thinking about only these articles of clothing, let's consider how many different ways Ed could possibly dress. There are three choices for the shirt he wears, and two choices for which pair of pants he wears. We can picture the six ways that he can dress right here. White shirt, black pants, white shirt, gray pants, blue shirt, black pants, blue shirt, gray pants, yellow shirt, black pants, or yellow shirt, gray pants. Six possible ways he can dress, and the reason it's six is because there are three possibilities for which shirt he wears, two choices for which pairs of pants he wears. Three times two is six. This is the essence of the multiplication principle. If one operation can be performed in a certain number of ways, say R, and another can be performed in a certain number of ways, let's say S, then the number of ways in which the two combined operations can be performed is obtained by simply multiplying those two number of ways together, the number of ways of doing the first thing times the number of ways of doing the second thing. In purchasing a car, Kim is choosing between five different models. She also has four choices for which bank provides the financing, and four insurance companies to choose from for the insurance. If she chooses to purchase a car, finance it through one of the banks, and insure it with one of the insurance companies, how many different ways can she proceed through all those steps? The answer is 5 times 4 times 4, or 80. 5 choices for her model of car, times 4 choices for which bank to do the financing with, times 4 choices for the insurance company. A tree diagram is a way of keeping track of the information when you're looking at various possibilities. Here's a tree diagram that we might draw to consider the different ways that Ed can dress. It's called a tree because it looks like a tree. There's a root at the bottom and then branches going upward from there. The tree diagram for the ways that Ed can dress, I've started out by considering which shirt he chooses to wear, the white one, the blue one, or the yellow one. And then no matter which shirt he picks, he can choose either of the two pairs of pants, the black pair or the gray pair. So the tree shows the six possibilities for dressing: white shirt, black pants, white shirt, gray pants, blue shirt, black pants, blue shirt, gray pants, or yellow shirt, black pants, yellow shirt, gray pants. Basically, you read from the bottom of the top. Each way that we can track from the root of the tree up to one of the top endpoints in the tree, or leaves if you want to call them that, represents a possible way to dress. Choosing blue shirt and black pants is one of the possibilities. There are six ways to track from the bottom to one of the outcomes shown at the top. Usually it's common practice to circle those loose ends because then each of the circles represents a possible way of dressing. The circle right here would represent the possibility that he wears the white shirt and the gray pants. The circle that the red arrow is pointing to would represent the way of dressing involving a blue shirt and gray pants. Now let's move on to a baseball series involving the Reds and the Cubs. We're going to draw a tree diagram to show all the ways that the series can go. They're going to be playing three games. Our tree diagram can show first the possibility for who wins game number one. The Reds or the Cubs might win. Then no matter what happens in that first game, we show the two possibilities for the second game. Reds or Cubs can win. And similarly, we continue a third level to show the outcome of the third game. So each of the circles at the top represents one possibility for the entire process. The circle that I'm pointing to now would represent one possible way the series could go, that way being that the Cubs win game number one, the Reds win game number two, and then the Reds win game number three. The eight blue circles representing the eight possible outcomes for the entire series. The red arrow is pointing at one of the outcomes, the one in which the Reds win game number one, the Cubs win game number two, and the Cubs win game number three. We're looking at a situation in which either the tree diagram concept, which we've just been through, or the multiplication principle is applicable. Since there are two possible outcomes for the first game, either the Reds win or the Cubs win, and two possible outcomes for the second game, Reds or Cubs could win, and similarly for the third game, the number of ways the entire series can go is 2 times 2 times 2, according to the multiplication principle, and that's 8. And those 8 different ways that the series can result are represented by the 8 circles in the tree diagram. Now we'll move to a tennis match, which is in some ways similar to the baseball series, but in one very important way quite different. Kim and Susan are playing tennis. The winner of the match will be the first person to win 2 sets. And we want to draw a tree to show all the ways that the match can go. We start out just as with the baseball series by showing the two possibilities for the first set. Either Kim or Susan wins. And same for the second set. The difference now is that we don't know to start with how many sets they will play. Because if Kim wins the first and the second set, then the match is over. If Susan wins the first and second set, then the match is over. But in the two cases where one of them wins the first set and the other one wins the second set, then they have to play a third set to determine who wins the match. So for the tennis example, there are only 6 possible outcomes since in some instances we don't play a third set. The 6 outcomes are represented by the 6 blue circles. And just to run through the 6 possibilities, Kim might win the match in 2 sets. Susan might win the match in 2 sets. Or Kim might win the first set, Susan the second, and Kim the third. Or Kim the first and Susan the next two. Or Susan might win the first and then Kim the next two, or Susan might win the first, Kim the second, and Susan the third. 6 possibilities for the way the match plays out. Unlike the 3-game baseball series where there were 8 possibilities. Diners at a pizza restaurant choose from 3 varieties of crust, 2 choices of sauce, 15 varieties of toppings. How many pizzas are possible if you're going to have one choice for crust, if you're going to choose one of the crusts, one of the sauces, and one of the toppings? The multiplication principle says you've got 3 times 2 times 15, or 90 possible ways of choosing your pizza if you're going to choose one of the 3 crusts, one of the 2 sauces, and one of the 15 toppings. Of course, if you're going to select more than one topping, then the counting gets more complicated, and in fact, that will be the topic of the next video after this one. Telephone numbers, 7 digits in a telephone number. How many 7-digit numbers are there? If the first digit must not be a 0 or 1. And second question, again, if the first digit can't be a 0, 1, and the last four digits are going to be all odd digits. For the first question, how many seven-digit phone numbers are there if the first digit must not be a 0 or 1? Let's think of simply filling in the blanks. If the first digit is not going to be a 0 or 1, that means it must be one of the digits 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, or 9. So that's 8 possibilities for the first digit, 8 ways to fill in the first blank. When we move to the second blank, any of the 10 digits, 0 through 9, can be used. So that means we have 10 choices for what number goes second. And similarly for each of the spots after that. So we have 8 choices for the first digit, times 10 for the second, times 10 for the third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh. So the total number of possibilities for the way the 7-digit number can be constructed would be 8 times 10 times 10 times 10 times 10 times 10 times 10. For the second question, what happens, same situation with the first digit, but now the last four digits have to be all odd digits. With the first digit, you could have any of the 8 digits other than 0 or 1. Then you can have anything in the next two spots. But since there are only 5 odd digits, 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9, for these last four spots where you have to have an odd digit, you only have 5 choices in each case. So to do the whole process, it's 8 choices for the first spot times 10 for the second, 10 for the third, and then for 5, and then 5 choices for each of the next 4 places, giving a total of 500,000 possibilities for the 7-digit number. A truck license plate has 2 letters followed by 4 digits. How many different license plates can be printed? Each of the 2 letters can be chosen in 26 ways, each of the 4 digits in 10 ways. So that's 26 possibilities for the first letter, times 26 for the second, times 10 for the next digit, times 10, times 10, times 10. 6,760,000 possible ways to make out a truck license plate if it has to fit this pattern. How many different 5-digit numbers can be formed from the digits 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 with various conditions placed on us? In the first variation on the question, we're allowed to use multiple copies of a digit. So for example, we have to use only these digits, but we can use as many of each type digit as we like. So 37,337 would be legal. It employs 3 threes and 2 sevens, but all the digits used are from these. So for this first variation on the question, for each of the 5 digits, we have 6 possible choices for which digit to use. So that's 6 choices for the first digit, times 6 for the second, times 6 for the third, times 6 for the fourth, times 6 for the fifth, or a total of 6 to the fifth power possible ways to make up a 5-digit number, according to the rules in Part A. When we move to Part B, the rules change and we're now not allowed to use any digit more than once. So in Part B, for the first digit in our 5-digit number, we can use any of the 6 possible digits we're choosing from. But then after one is used up, when we come to the next spot, we only have 5 remaining digits to choose from. And then after we've used up 2 of the digits, that leaves us only 4 possibilities for the next, and then 3, and then 2, and then 1. So our total number of possible ways to form a 5-digit number, choosing from these digits and using each digit no more than once, is only 720. For example, if we chose 5 as our first digit, then when we came to the second digit, we can't use a 5, so it would have to be either the 2, 3, 4, 6, or 7, only 5 choices for the next spot, and so forth. In Part C, how many of the possibilities from Part A would be numbers that are less than 50,000. Well, let's see. If we're going to have a number, a five-digit number, which is less than 50,000, then the first digit has to be a 2, 3, or 4. So the first digit would have to be one of these three, three choices for the first digit. But then after the first digit, the remaining choices, where we were allowed to repeat copies of the digits, could be any of the six digits. So we'll have a number, we'll have a five-digit number less than 50,000 if the first digit is one of the first three, and then the next four digits can be any of the six digits whatsoever. Three choices for the first, times six, times six, times six, times six. 3,888 possibilities for a five-digit number that satisfies this condition. And finally, in part D, how many of the possibilities in part B, where we're not repeating digits, would give us a five-digit number less than 50,000? Well, again, we would have to start with either a 2, 3, or 4 if we're going to have a five-digit number less than 50,000. So one of those would have to be chosen as our first digit. The second digit could be any of the remaining five. But now, having used up two of the digits, that leaves us only four choices for the third digit. We choose one for that, and then that would leave us only three choices for the next, two for the next, and then only one choice for the final spot. 3 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 is 360 ways to make up a five-digit number that satisfies the conditions in part D. Kathy's grandmother took Kathy shopping. They found some items that Kathy likes. Three dresses, four sweaters, two blouses. If her grandmother decides to buy her one of each type item, that is one dress, one sweater, and one blouse, how many possibilities are there for the articles of clothing her grandmother buys? In the second variation on the question, her grandmother is not so generous. In part B, her grandmother is going to buy only one article of clothing from all the categories. So in part A, she's buying three different things, one of each type, and in part B, only one item. How does that affect the number of possibilities? In part A, we have simply a very basic illustration of the multiplication principle. If the grandmother is buying one of the three dresses, one of the four sweaters, and one of the two blouses, that's three choices for dress times four choices for sweater times two choices for blouse. There are 24 different ways the grandmother can buy the three items she's going to buy. But in part B, it really is only a question of how many items there are to choose from altogether, since she's only going to buy one item. The three dresses, four sweaters, and two blouses combined makes 3 plus 4 plus 2, 9 articles of clothing. The grandmother's going to buy one of those 9 articles. So the number of possibilities is obtained by adding the number of dresses plus the number of sweaters plus the number of blouses, rather than multiplying. So for part B, the answer is 9. So when you think about it, the difference in part A and part B boils down to the difference in multiplying in part A because of the multiplication principle, and adding in part B because we're simply combining all the articles of clothing together and choosing one from the whole batch.